Here's this week's tribe trivia. Here's the question. What is the largest U.S. state by land mass? A. Texas. B. Michigan. C. Alaska. Or D. California?
Welcome, Indians, to another great Thursday. Here are your weekly announcements.
Boys and girls varsity bowling has a game at Xenia at 4 p.m. January 12th.
The boys varsity wrestling team has a meet on January 11th at 6 p.m.
Attention seniors, senior pictures are due no later than January 30th, so make sure to get them turned in.
Monday is Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Day. Make sure you take a moment to reflect on the civil rights.
And now we go to Parker with the weather. Stay warm.
All right, that's all for your weekly announcements. Goodbye, Indians.
Welcome to Piper's Pogoing Lessons.
Once upon a time, there's a man named Martin Luther King Jr. It's funny to think about because now we know his name so well. But at one time, he was just a kid. Like, maybe you're a kid watching this. Well, he was a kid too. Well, maybe you're a grown-up. That's okay too. Former kids are welcome here. I don't discriminate. Martin Luther King grew up to be a great man, of course. But things weren't all that great in the world while he was growing up. Not everybody was treated like they were somebody. And I believe that you should treat everybody like it's their birthday. But they didn't do that. People looked at the color of their skin. And that's how they decided if they were friends or not. Not cool, man. That didn't make him feel good. That didn't make anybody feel good. But his parents helped him grow up. He went to church. He learned about love. He grew up to be a minister to help a lot of people. He did all sorts of cool stuff. He helped a lot of people learn about love, too. But still, he looked around and said, things should be better. He wanted to change things, so he did stuff. He decided, instead of spreading the hate, he would spread the love. He wanted to bring people together. Where people were hurting, he stepped in to help. He marched with them, he walked with them. He walked arm in arm with everyone. Sometimes it didn't go well, but he kept going. Sometimes he ended up in prison, but he kept going. Some people didn't like him, but he kept going. Some days were hard, but he kept going. Love does that, it just keeps going, even when things are dark. And, well, I don't like this part of the story, but things did get pretty dark. Someone who didn't agree with him shot him. He died in April 1968. Now, keep pressing it. Why are you telling us this sad story? Come on. I know, look, I'm sorry, but it happened. I don't like that happened. Now, I gotta tell you something. When things aren't awesome, it can be tough. And things will always be awesome, but your response can be. Martin Luther King's response? It was awesome. Today, I just wanted us to think about this. Isn't it cool that we can change things? Like any of us, anybody. He dreamed and he changed things. And he dreamed and he kept sharing his dreams. They became not just his dream, a lot of people's dream. Like this one. I have a dream that little black boys and black girls will join hands with white boys and white girls and become sisters and brothers. That's a pretty good dream. Let's dream like that. That could change things. Ford being Dr. King's son, Dr. Martin Luther King III. And you can find our conversation in my new book, Two Presidents Guide to Being Awesome. He's a really great leader, and he even wrote a book called My Daddy, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. It's so good that I want to book it forward. I'm pledging to send 30 copies to a school in my town. What about you? How can you book it forward? Here's a few ways that people are doing it already. Look at this, it's amazing. It's really cool to see it spread. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for being awesome, people. See you next week. Once upon a time, there's a man named Martin Luther King Jr. It's funny to think about because now we know his name so well, but at one time, he was just a kid. Like, maybe you're a kid watching this. Well, he was a kid too. Well, maybe you're a grown-up. That's okay too. Former kids are welcome here. I don't discriminate. Martin Luther King grew up to be a great man, of course, but things weren't all that great in the world while he was growing up. Not everybody was treated like they were somebody. And I believe that you should treat everybody like it's their birthday. But they didn't do that. People looked at the color of their skin. And that's how they decided if they were friends or not. Not cool, man. That didn't make him feel good. That didn't make anybody feel good. But his parents helped him grow up. He went to church. He learned about love. He grew up to be a minister to help a lot of people. He did all sorts of cool stuff. He helped a lot of people learn about love, too. But still, he looked around and said, things should be better. He wanted to change things, so he did stuff. He decided, instead of spreading the hate, he would spread the love. He wanted to bring people together. Where people were hurting, he stepped in to help. He marched with them, he walked with them. He walked arm in arm with everyone. Sometimes it didn't go well, but he kept going. Sometimes he ended up in prison, but he kept going. Some people didn't like him, but he kept going. Some days were hard, but he kept going. Love does that, it just keeps going, even when things are dark. And, well, I don't like this part of the story, but things did get pretty dark. Someone who didn't agree with him shot him. He died in April 1968. Now, keep pressing it. Why are you telling us this sad story? Come on. I know, Linda, look, I'm sorry, but it happened. And I don't like that it happened. Now, I gotta tell you something. When things aren't awesome, it can be tough. And things will always be awesome, but your response can be. Martin Luther King's response? It was awesome. Today I just wanted us to think about this. Isn't it cool that we can change things? Like any of us, anybody. He dreamed and he changed things. And he dreamed and he kept sharing his dreams. They became not just his dream, a lot of people's dream. Like this one. I have a dream that little black boys and black girls will join hands with white boys and white girls and become sisters and brothers. That's a pretty good dream. Let's dream like that. That could change things. I had the honor of being Dr. King's son, Dr. Martin Luther King III. And you can find our conversation in my new book, Two Presidents Guide to Being Awesome. He's a really great leader, and he even wrote a book called My Daddy, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. It's so good that I want to book it forward. I'm pledging to send 30 copies to a school in my town. What about you? How can you book it forward? Here's a few ways that people are doing it already. Look at this, it's amazing. It's really cool to see it spread. Thanks, everybody. Thanks for being awesome, people. See you next week.